Welcome back to Eve Market, the weekly look at the MR market. Well, it has been almost 2 weeks, but well, at least this is my last day of holiday, so tomorrow I can start working again, and then we're also gonna pick up the normal schedule of all the videos again for every Sunday. It's gonna be in the beginning of first weekend of September. I won't come out because I'm away again. A long weekend is the plan, so yeah. But we're back with the market check here. We're gonna start off straight with Tritanium. It's a little bit of a bad data point here, or someone has been buying in for a ridiculous price again. Yep. Someone bought in from Tritanium for 9 ISK again. Some people still don't understand, but it seems to be always happening on the Sunday, so I'm not sure if that is right. So Tritanium seems to be going slightly up and down, pretty much still staying around the 5x per unit, and it's not really doing anything strange. It's very, very stable currently. Tritanium is not going anywhere, so we're just gonna go straight for the prices. Seller's price 515 and buyer's price 499. That's even exactly the same price as 2 weeks ago. Well, that was also 499, so no change on the Tritanium price at all in 2 weeks' time. That's, you don't see that really often. But, well, it stayed like this. Then we go on for ferrite. Really, someone bought for 95 here. Bad data points. Is someone tricking me here or something? Again, a bad data point here, so it's hard to see what it's really doing. What the price is doing here for ferrite. It seems to be pretty stable, but it's not able to see it, what it is doing, because the line is just flat for me to see it. So we go straight to the prices. Seller's price is 11 ISK per unit for the buyers in the 10.68. That is a slight increase since 2 weeks ago. It was 2 weeks. 2 weeks ago, it was 10.40. So ferrite did indeed hit its lowest point and starting to slowly crawl up in price, going up. 2 weeks ago it was the 1040, so it was sitting around here. So some orders have popped up, there's a bigger one here even. So this is slightly pushing the price up for ferrite. It's not a lot, but it's going up. I have Maxelon. Maxelon is definitely going up. It's only going up for like 1.5 weeks. 1.5 to 2 weeks, it is increasing in price. We had here about just a little bit more of a week ago, it went straight to about 46, 47 even. After that, it dropped again below the 45, but then again, it started to increase. The Saturday, we're sitting at the 45 per unit, also decent amount of sales here on the Saturday and on the Thursday. Today we're sitting a little bit lower, but expect this one to go higher towards the 45 or even higher. But Maxelon is clearly starting to increase in price here in MR. Seller's price 47.98, almost 48 per unit. Buyer's price 45.20. That's clearly a difference since 2 weeks ago. 41.04 was 2 weeks ago the price. So Maxelon has gone up like 4 ISK per unit easily. So Maxelon is going up in price. Next one, Isogen. Also clearly that went pretty quickly up. He had even reached almost 120. That's very high for Isogen. But for now it's staying on average, staying just below the 100, and then it has even a slight drop here. Price dropped a bit. It seems to be very, very slightly dropping again. It's not a lot. Let's look a little bit at 10 days. Yeah, it's very, very slightly dropping in price again after the increase here. So we had a spike here on prices. You can see also around here. I don't know my mouse is recorded, but around here there's a little bit higher spikes on sales, and that's probably pushed this price up. On this point here it was 110, and now it's slowly dropping again. Seller's price 107.45, buyer's price 105.79. Clearly a lot higher than 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks it was 95.10. So there's clearly an increase of it. And let's see if Noxium is still dropping in price. Yep, Noxium is still dropping. It's all going on for a pretty long time. We had a little bit of a spike here on the Friday. Also, the sales amount went up. It up just before that. So Max Loan went up here for a moment to 470. After that, it started dropping again in price. So Oxygen is still going down for a pretty long time. It's already going down for like 3 months. There was a little bit uptrend here, but go for 6 months. Yeah, so basically Noxium is almost dropping for like half a year, almost. Prices for it, seller's price 469.91, buyer's price 461. That went up since 2 weeks ago, because 2 weeks ago it was really, really low. It was 425.36. So buyer's price for Noxium is going up. So keep in mind in that. Still, the graph set is going down, but the buyer's price is going up. Then we have Zyndryd. Zyndryd is still going down. Very, very stable, very stable drop on it. It's not really making spikes from top or a little bit high. It's really, really nice line going down in price. Looks like we're sitting around the 1300 now, and I don't seem to be gonna stop soon this drop. Seller's price 1464.94, buyer's price 1405.5, just above it. That is a slight drop since 2 weeks ago. 1421 was the price 2 weeks ago. Megasite. Megasite is still dropping pretty hard. It's really going down quick. There was even a huge sales here. That was on Wednesday. There was a big spike on sales on Megasite. People thinking, oh, it's dropping too quickly. Let's dump it on the market, but give Megasite an extra bigger drop in price. And we seem to be hitting for the 1550. It's the way we're starting to go for Megasite. Sales amount are pretty normal, so there's probably a bigger supply on the market. There's clearly a bigger supply. So current seller's price is 1651 for Megasite, but this I'm surely gonna drop soon. Buyer's price 1523.92. Well, you saw on the graph, it's clearly dropping. It's definitely lower than 2 weeks ago. That was 1625.34. So clearly, Megasite is dropping. It doesn't seem to gonna be stopping soon. It's really gonna keep on going for a while. Then we have the last one. It's Morphite. Morphite is really going up and down, as usual in the market. It really picked up its normal thing, sitting between the 10,500 and basically between the 13,000, which sitting between. But really rapidly moving off the price. We're sitting currently just below the 12,500 per unit. But I can never tell what Morphin is going to do in a mob, because it's really so rapidly moving. If you look at the graph in Gita, it's a lot different, I think. I'm not even sure anymore, because I haven't looked at Gita for a while. Been there this week, didn't look at it. But yeah, Morphite has always been so bouncy here in the market. It's pretty normal site here. So prices for Morphite, for the seller's price, 12,789.31. Buyer's price, 10,906. That's clearly has dropped a decent amount since 2 weeks ago, because that was 12,100. So that's a nice drop for Morphite. Then let's take a quick look at some regular salvage here from the MR region. That's some salvage. Armor plates, pretty stable 2 weeks ago. After that, it started going up again. Then it suddenly makes a huge drop from the 92,000 per unit to about almost 86,000 per unit. Straight after that, it started recovering again to a normal price for armor plates. And today, we're seeing a little bit high towards the 92,000 per unit again. Seller's price 93,898, that's more than 500 units. And buyer's price 92,000 per unit. That is an increase since 2 weeks ago. It was 90,100. So that went up in price. But not just sugars. 2 weeks ago it had a new record on the highest price, and we're gonna have a new record again. But also still going very quickly up in price. So if you have lying something around, you probably can make a huge amount of money off it, but I don't think it's gonna keep on going too long, because this uptrend is already going on for a pretty long while. It was very low here, 36,000, and now it's going so quickly up. I wish I bought in a load here, because I could make so much money, but it's going, still going up very, very fast. How long this is now happening? At least a month. Okay, this is a 3 month chart, so this is almost in the middle, so it's seeing at least about a month, almost 1.5 months, that it's already going up so rapidly in price. This is not going to keep on going much longer for sure, because this is just insane prices that we're getting for burn logic circuits. So prices for it: seller's price 48,998, seller's price 48,000, just above it, and that's clearly a new record. It was 2 weeks ago, it was 42,250. Even that was a high price. And also this, of course, is a new highest price record for this year for burn logic circuits. Fried interface circuits are a bit of weird moving here. It was very stable here, then it made a spike to 5,000, a small drop. And then made a huge drop to below the 4,200, well, it was 4,100. And then straight away recovered again towards the 4,800. Someone sold it for a very low price then. Then it recovered again towards pretty normal price, 4,800, 900. And then after 4 days, it suddenly dropped again towards 4,000, just above 4,200. That was even the Friday and the Saturday, yesterday. And for today, we're sitting a bit high. So, fried interface circuits currently can a very low price and a pretty high price, at least about 400 different per unit. So, really rapidly moving. It seems to be depending on the sellers and buyers, apparently. But not too many buyers anymore. Yeah, it's starting to drop. So, this may gonna show this price is gonna drop more towards 4,200 soon. Seller's price 4,759, buyer's price 4,500 per unit. Still, that's a drop since 2 weeks ago. 4,830 was 2 weeks ago. Melted capacitor consoles still very, very stable, but now then it spikes and you're staying on that, but it seems to have dropped also. Yeah, it was a little bit moving around, and then suddenly started pretty much staying flat at the 6,000. Made the jump up, stayed for 3 days there, jumped down again towards the 6,000. Another jump here. So basically, melted capacitors are staying between the 6 and 7,000 per unit. It was very low a while ago, sitting 3 to 2,000 even. I got even a load of that. It's just moving. Just not moving anymore at all, staying just between the 6 and 7,000. That's one unit. I'm not gonna bother with that. 6,889.72 for the seller's price. For the buyer's price, just above the 6,000, 6,006. It's a very, very slight drop since 2 weeks ago, because that was 6,010. So that's very, very little movement in that. Very stable currently melt capacitors. If you look at a lot of years back, at least about a half year back, you see the melt capacitors made a huge drop towards the 2,000, and now suddenly shooting up towards the 6,000, and pretty much staying on the 6,000 now. It's not going anywhere, sitting for a few months around the 6,000 already, or for a few weeks, sorry. Trip power circuits. Went slightly up in price. Had a spike here towards 30,000, that's pretty high. On average, you can clearly see it's going up, with sliding down now and then, slowing down in the uptrend, but it's still going up. We're sitting currently out in 29,000, we've been sitting here for 3 days. Yesterday suddenly dropped to just above the 27,000 per unit, and then here it went up. Oh no, it's today's point, it can still change, but it's still sitting around 27,500, yeah, around that price. Trip power circuits starting to move. Seller's price 28,750. This is only 3 units, so don't pick that up. This is more than 500 units. And then buyer's price 27,800. Clearly that went up. 26,751 was the price 2 weeks ago. Then again, gonna quick look at the Plex. Plex is still moving rapidly between the prices. See a lot of lines. It's really jumping between a lot of different prices. On average, we are seem to be sitting just below the 975 million is per unit per Plex. That is what I'm gonna say. It can go up to about 980 million per Plex. So the seller's price currently 990 million. Perplex and buyer's price in 966.6 million perplex. Let's see, 2 weeks ago, 970 million, so it's a slight drop of the Plex price. So, this was this week's look at the MR market. For everybody that stung the sub on my channel, thanks to this. Person that dropped it on his blog and on the Twitter on Tweetfleet and stuff. I gained a lot of new followers on my channel. I don't even know how many I got. I think between 15 and 20 or even more. Everybody that's subbed for this, thank you, and please press the like button. It's really gonna help me out. So thanks for watching. See you all next week again. Fly safe.